nađe vaše dokumente?
Пожалуйста.
Куда вы направляетесь?
Close, Dr. Ashton. If you want to get that overnight to Janetta's cell, I better head out to the post office.
All right. Do me a favor and check with my father before you go. Make sure he doesn't need anything.
Sure.
One more thing. Did you get the mail?
Yeah, it's right here.
Great.
You'll have it tomorrow, first thing. That's right. I'll call you again to tell you when it's ready to be picked up. Of course, I'm sure. What are you doing?
I was just... Dr. Ashton told me to ask if there's anything you need from town.
So you sneak up behind me to ask?
No, I wasn't sneaking. I just walked in.
What's going on?
I'm just filling your new assistant in on the rules of the house.
Rules? Well, I wasn't aware that my house had any rules. And I didn't think that the guests here would be the ones to make them if there were.
I just don't want people sneaking up on me when I'm busy. That's all.
I'll have to apologize for my father here. He takes his trains pretty seriously.
It's okay.
This came in the mail. It's something I have to sign for personally. It's probably those DNA samples I sent for. Do you need anything from town, Dad?
No, nothing.
Julie, you're gonna have to forgive my old man. He thinks he's earned the right to be bitter because he's a chemist with a PhD. Spent his whole life making bug spray. If I'd have known what a pain in the ass he was gonna be, I never invited him to come stay.
When did he move in?
About a year ago. Seems longer. You okay?
Quebec's sure a lot colder than home.
You're not gonna change your mind about spending spring break up here, are you?
No way. I wouldn't pass up the chance to intern under you for anything.
All right.
Hello.
Dr. Ashton? Or should I say Dr. Ashbine?
Who is this?
Never mind. I want to buy the toxin formula.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I know you have it. If you won't sell it, we'll have to trade for it.
Trade? What do you mean by trade?
You'll see, Alexander. I'll be in touch.
Where was he all this time?
He and my mom divorced when I was about 8. We moved to Canada. He went to Chicago to work.
So you guys must be doing a lot of catching up these days.
Oh, mostly I just listen to stories about how the military-industrial complex corrupted pure science.
So the whole time you were growing up, he wasn't around at all? He didn't follow your career?
Yeah, he called sometimes. Visited once in a while. I guess he knew what I was up to.
My folks are divorced. It was hard for me, but we stayed real close. My dad's so proud of me. I bet your dad is too.
Maybe. It's hard to be impressed when you're a genius like him. You still cold? There's a coat in the back.
There he is. We'll take him when he comes out.
Old Lady Franklin. She always takes forever. Julie, take the car, go to the gas station, fill it up, and I'll meet you at the market.
Sure.
Shit. Where's he going? Get after him.
Not here.
Just a little girl with little titties.
What's your name?
Julie.
Well, Julie, say hi to the camera.
Jesus Christ!
Besides her resume?
No. She was very bright. Her professor recommended her. God, I have to call her parents.
We'll do that. Check them out, too.
What do you mean, check them? She's just a student, Bob.
Mike, this kind of thing just doesn't happen up here. They wore hoods, shot up the gas station, stole the security video recorder. It was a professional hit.
Kid.
All I'm saying is we don't know who she could have been involved with.
What about that packaging slip? There was no package.
Could have been a mistake. We'll check that too. These guys, they might have been trying to get some money from you. Kidnapping for ransom kind of thing.
Dr. Ashton? Michael Ashton?
Yes.
I'm Superintendent Robert Ogilvy. This is Inspector Craig and Sergeant Penny Johnson.
Hi.
We're a special homicide unit with the RCMP.
Hey, excuse me, Dr. Ashton, is this your father?
Michael, I'm not feeling up to all this right now. I have to get some rest.
Oh, but Mr. Ashton, we would like a few words.
I need my rest.
You'll have to excuse my father. He's, well, he's like that quite a bit, actually. It's charming.
Your father is also a geneticist, am I correct?
No, chemist. Retired.
According to the report, he moved back here a year ago.
Yeah, that's correct.
Has he been working at all recently?
Working and making my life miserable, but I don't see what any of that has to do with what happened today.
Just being thorough.
That's it, then?
Well, unless there's something that you haven't already told the police.
Today sort of looked to me like an organized carjacking of some kind, or a attack on me.
And is there any way that you can identify any of them?
They wore ski masks.
There were three of them. They got in a blue American car and drove away.
And all of that is in this report?
Yeah.
Thank you once again, Dr. Ashton.
Thank you.
The local police don't have the resources to leave anyone here. And whoever did this could be back.
So you do think that I was some kind of a target?
Well, we're still trying to put all of the pieces together, but until we do, we feel that somebody should be here.
I think I can take care of myself.
Well, I'll tell you what. If you can teach me everything that I need to know about splicing genes in an hour, I will teach you everything you need to know about my job. And then I'll leave. Deal?
Voice recognition and a cellular tracer. Minds are coming up in the world.
We try to keep up. Expecting anyone tonight?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay. If anything changes, will you let me know? Because otherwise, I'll trip the perimeter.
Okay.
No, nothing. It's completely quiet. I think the old guy went to bed. So I'll check back at 5? 3. Okay. Mike? Yeah, he's still up.
Do you need something?
No, I was just looking around. Is this where you do all your work?
Yes, it is. I moved it all here a couple of years ago. I was wasting too much time commuting to Montreal.
What is it exactly that you do?
Besides trying to hook the occasional trout. Right now, I'm genetically altering skin grafts to try and make them grow faster, starting with frog skin.
What's that?
That is a Bond with Dad project.
Bond with Dad?
Yeah, he had some notes on an organic pesticide, and thought we could work them together, you know, to sort of bond with Dad.
Oh.
Didn't work.
The pesticide.
Not that either.
I saw that you had some coffee upstairs. Do you mind if I make some?
Help yourself.
Chance, Miss Johnson. As far as I'm concerned, you've made an absolute bloody dog's dinner of it.
You told me that I was supposed to protect them. You didn't tell me the old guy was a flight risk. And you still haven't told me who he is.
And she's right, Overly. She's working in the dark on this.
Besides the point, she should...
What the hell's going on here? I want to know what you know about my father.
Well, I'm afraid we know about as much as you do. And we are going to need your help if we're going to find him.
You're not getting any help from me unless you level with me first.
Tell him. Just tell him.
Tell him? Tell him what? The brigade will terminate his father if he doesn't come in peacefully.
Wait a minute, there's a termination order out on his father?
Only as a last resort.
You are off this case. You can report back to Montreal. Tell your superiors you are available for reassignment.
For God's...
My case, my decision. Search this house right now.
That's right, Robert Ogilvy. He says he's Royal Canadian Mounted Police, but it sounds more British to me.
Honey, I'm sorry. Forget Ogilvy. You did the best you could with what you knew.
Well, it sounds like there's a lot that I don't know. And why do we need him?
Oh, because this whole thing started with him, so we're stuck with him. I'm really sorry, Penny. You know, when Doug was hit, I thought the best thing for you would be to put you on the same case.
Well, it was. You know how much I want to find his killer.
Sure, we all do. I know it's only been a year, but I also know Doug would have wanted you to carry on with your life.
I'm trying.
I know. Listen, if I find anything out, I'll call you.
I know you will.
It's public information, though. I mean, they can't hide it from me, can they? Okay. Well, no, I would appreciate that. Thank you. I want you out of my house.
Dr. Ashton, this isn't easy. You have been through a great deal, but believe me, we are only trying to help.
What's that?
It's a court order. To secure these premises. You see, if you want us to try and find your father, we'll need to start investigating this scene.
You can forget that. I have the right to verify your identity. Until I hear back from the Public Complaints Commission, you're not doing anything.
Yes, what you say is true. By the same token, I could have you arrested, but that wouldn't do any of us any good, would it? So I make a deal. We promise not to touch anything until you are convinced. In the meantime, we believe you're still in danger. So you'll have to let us stay. At least until the Complaints Commission call back.
Head of security, please. Yes, I'll hold. Hello, this is Sergeant Johnson from the RCMP. I'm investigating a homicide, and I need to review a videotape from one of your ATM security cameras. Can you just hold it there, please? Can you go in on that? Can you get any closer? Can you clean that up? Tighten up a bit. Oh my God.
claims commission will back us on the search warrant, we should wait.
Clock is ticking, Krager. Stop bitching and search the old man's room.
Turn around slow. Don't make me shoot you. Do it. Take off the mask. Now. You.
Just take it easy with that thing, okay? You don't want to hurt anybody.
Who are you, really?
CIA. We're CIA.
Central Intelligence? Up here? What about Ogilvy?
No, he's MI6, British Intelligence.
Jesus Christ, what the hell's going on?
I don't know.
Come on.
Look, they haven't told me anything, okay? They've taken me off the case. But I did just see a bank security video of the man who killed Julie. His name is Manic, and he's a CIA trigger man that they hire sometimes.
Works for you.
Not me, them, maybe, or some other road group on the inside. I don't know. I'm trying to make sense of all of this myself. Okay, there's not a lot of time. There is a termination order out on your father, and they will kill him if they find him before I can.
Kill him?
That's right. So if you think you might know where he is, then you need to tell me now, because that's the only way that we're going to get to the bottom of this.
Well, I don't. I don't know anything.
Nothing.
I swear to you, I have no idea what any of this is about.
All right, well, then I need to go so that I can find him.
You're taking me with you. If you do find him, he wouldn't talk to you. You need me.
Believe me, you are in way over your head here.
You think so? I got the drop on you, didn't I?
One of the basics. Always search your prisoner. If I wanted to kill you, I could have done it already.
Okay. You're tough. I get it. I'm still going.
Yeah. Not with this.
You know, I'm pretty good with that. I've hit a lot of ducks with that thing.
Yeah, but we're not going to be shooting anything with wax. You think I'd give you an empty gun?
You think I'd trust you?
Stay low, okay? Crawl under the beam.
Great! Stop!
Shoot! Just run!
Shooting at us?
Keep moving!
Getting pretty close!
You'll give away our position!
Why they were trying to kill me?
They weren't trying to kill you. They
Bullshit!
Thought you were being kidnapped.
Now what?
A woman I know in Vermont. Maybe she can meet us someplace halfway.
Oh, maybe?
She might know something about your father. I'm gonna drive. You sleep.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I'm sorry, there is really nothing more that I can tell you.
Thank you for that, Natalia.
I hope it helps. Douglas was a wonderful man. I was truly sorry to hear what happened. You must be Michael.
Ashton. Mike Ashton.
Good luck in your search, Mike. До свидания, Penny.
До свидания, Natalia.
До свидания? She's a Russian?
Yeah.
Who's Douglas?
He was a friend.
What does he have to do with all this?
He was working this case about a year ago. He was killed.
So you're here for revenge, is that it?
I'm here to find out the truth.
So am I. Who is the woman?
Look, once we find your father, then I'll answer the questions.
I'm afraid it doesn't work that way. You said that when you spoke to her, you'd tell me what I needed to know. Now you spoke to her, and I want to know. Who is she?
Let go of me. Natalia Vladik. She was ex-KGB.
Ex-KGB? And she knows something about my father.
Your father told you that he was from Amsterdam, didn't he?
Yes. We're Dutch. I've seen the pictures. We're from,
East Germany.
That can't be right.
Look, we should get out of the open.
What else did she tell you?
Your father's name wasn't always Ashton. It was Ashbein. Look, we're stepping through the looking glass now, Mike, and a lot of what you thought was true isn't gonna be. But no matter what we find, you have to stick with me on this.
Yeah. Yeah, look, I understand that, but why did he change his name?
I don't know exactly, but oh, shit.
What?
There are eyes on us.
Eyes?
That gray car over there, they're watching us. Come on.
Dead.
Those guys.
You were defending yourself, Mike.
Yeah. I know.
Those are the guys who killed Julie.
That was manic?
Definitely.
Well, then we're going back to my house.
Where are you going?
Whatever your guys are looking for, they didn't find it. This might be your spy game, but it's my life, and I'm sick of being pushed around. Drive up to the house.
Because that would be stupid. Gosh. Looks like we're too late. They'll have a legitimate search warrant. It's all evidence now.
Oh, shit, they're tearing my house apart.
Just stay down, okay? Be right back.
Thanks.
pal Ogilvy's back.
That's right.
What about the house? You find anything?
Reams of paper.
We'll need people who know how to read it.
It'll take forever. We have to find Ashton. I've asked the Poe to put out a red notice. They'll have his picture everywhere. The results will come through to the website at your office.
Fine, I'll get a team together. I can request backup as soon as we get a lead.
Oh, no, you won't.
What?
You won't do anything without my express authorization.
What are you talking about? This is CIA jurisdiction.
To hell with jurisdiction. The WMD office gave me full authority, and this is my operation.
You're going to slow things up.
So I slow things up. It is my choice, but from now on, everything goes through me. Everything.
Isn't there something we can do besides just crawling around out here?
Like what? We can't beat an Interpol search. Come on, let's go.
Maybe we can join them.
What?
The Interpol search. The website to your office. It's probably part of a secure intranet, right?
Well, of course. That's what makes the system hack-proof.
Yeah, sure it does, from the outside.
What are you thinking now, Mike?
I'm thinking there's a way that we can get information off that intranet from the outside, but we gotta set it up from the inside first.
Well, that's gonna be tough because Krieger's in charge of our computer system.
We'll just have to make sure he isn't there.
And how are you gonna do that?
Well, I'm not.
It's not all CIA.
Taxpayers will be glad to hear that.
Okay, the restaurant's over here.
It's quaint.
Give me the phone. What's wrong?
What is WMD?
Who told you that?
Ogilvy said it. What is it?
We don't have time for this.
Well, then I suggest you start talking pretty quickly. Otherwise, this isn't going to happen at all.
Weapons of mass destruction, WMD.
Weapons? Mass destruction? What does that have to do with my father?
Yeah, I told you there were some things that you might not want to know. Now give me the phone.
If it has to do with my father, I want to hear everything.
All right, Mike. Your father wasn't a chemist. Not the way you thought he was. He was a specialist in your line of work. He was a geneticist.
Why would he lie about that?
Because your father was a weapons maker. Biochemical weapons. He worked for the Russians during the Cold War.
See, biochemical weapons are only good for one thing, killing people, thousands and thousands of people.
Yeah, but I'm sure that your father will be able to explain.
What kind of explanation could I possibly want to hear from anyone that would do that?
Yeah, but we still don't have all the answers. I mean, once we find him, he'll be...
Maybe someone like that doesn't need to be found.
No, Mike, somebody like that is exactly the kind of person that needs to be found. There might be more than his life at stake. Here he comes. Okay.
Call me when you get in there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, okay. I am here.
Okay, good. Now, use your password to get into the system just like you usually do.
Got it.
Okay, what do you see?
I see lots of stuff. I see lists of programs.
Look for something called administrative tools.
What's it called again?
Administrative tools. Oh, shit. Shit. Krieger, he's coming back across the street.
Well, right now?
Did you find it?
Not yet.
You gotta get out of there. Penny, forget it. You gotta get out of there.
Steve, I'd love to show you my ID, but I have to first get it from the office.
No problem, Mr. Krieger.
Penny!
Wait. Administrative tools. I have it. Just tell me what the next thing is.
Administrative properties.
Okay, I got it. I'm in. The prompt password is right here. I can do this.
Hurry! He is gonna be there in a second!
I'm typing in my password right now. I'm almost done.
You have to back out of the system first!
Come on!
Come on, you gotta get out! Penny, you gotta get out of there!
Oh, my God. You scared me half to death. What are you doing here?
I'm waiting for you.
I was in the restaurant.
Is that where we were supposed to meet?
Well, I thought that's what we said. Anyway, I left my wallet. Come on, my vodka's getting warm.
I am so hungry.
He didn't say anything else about the case.
Nothing.
He doesn't suspect that we've hooked up.
Doesn't seem that way. There.
Okay. This should go pretty quickly once I get in. Good work.
Great. There, Lone Condor, that's the code that we were using.
Lone Condor? You gotta be kidding.
Some things are just like in the movies. So now what?
Now I build a firewall between us and them. It'll give me 60 seconds to delete incoming information before it goes to their website. They don't really have anything, though. Although they're watching the borders and the airports, stuff like that.
So we just wait and watch.
It'll beep if something comes in. How was dinner?
Oh, great. You know, it's a terrific little restaurant. You know what? You didn't eat, did you? I'll cook.
No, that's all right.
No. I can cook.
Actually, could I grab a shower?
Sure, and there are some clothes in the closet that might fit you.
Then I was off to Harvard to study physiology. I thought I could get the old man's attention. Then I went into genetics. Did okay.
Okay? Oh, come on. You got straight A's.
Yeah.
You finished top of your class. You published your thesis. You had headhunters chasing after you. I read your file. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Anyway, it didn't work.
What?
I never did get the old man's attention. Ended up just like him. Well, not exactly like him.
It's terrible that you had to find out this way. I'm sorry, I really am.
He was bigger than life. When I was a kid, the things I didn't know about him, I made them up. I guess I made him into something he wasn't.
It's not your fault that he is who he is.
I know that.
It's funny actually because I was thinking the same thing, but I haven't done it in a while, you know. The sender's not even sure it's a match.
No, that's him. That's definitely a match. It's my dad. I got 60 seconds to edit this out before it reaches our website.
Where's it coming from?
Got it. It's a bank camera video. Luxembourg.
Luxembourg?
Yeah, he's in Europe.
Doug had a friend who did business in Luxembourg.
Huh. Here's a night flight to Paris. Come on, before Ogilvy finds this some other way.
Can I have a minute?
Who exactly is Henty?
He worked with Doug for years until he was wounded down in South America. Now he's a security specialist. Very well connected. Whatever we need, he can get. There he is.
Henty, how are you? It's been a while. Long time.
Long time. This is Mike Ashton, Russell Henty.
Pleased to meet you, Mike. Sorry to hear about everything that's gone down. I just am glad I can do a little something to help out. Come on, I'm out front.
So, any luck with things?
Of course. I checked them out completely. He's been in and out of at least three banks, wired in some cash, shuffled some accounts around. He's probably getting ready to leave soon.
And he's still here?
Alzette Hotel. Using the name of Carl Sykes.
You're amazing.
Don't I know it? Huh? Not bad for a pensioned off ex-spy?
Private security must pay better than I thought.
On the edge of town. Handy for the banks, I guess. But it made him easy to spot.
Any word from Ogilvy?
Nothing. As far as I know, he's not into this yet.
Oh, he will be.
Hey, would you quit worrying, Penny?
It's my job.
We're gonna be there in a few minutes, okay? I'm driving, you'll get there.
Fine.
Just calm down.
Valet said he went out a couple hours ago. Didn't take any luggage with him.
But he still checked in.
Do you know that guy?
The valet?
Mm-hmm.
Nah, just greased his palm a little.
Take a good look.
Yeah?
His sleeves, they're too short. And I'll bet anything those aren't his pants. And then there's this other guy downstairs who's taken forever to check in.
You got me there, Penny. Didn't realize I was getting so rusty.
All right, you guys hang here. I'm gonna take another walk around.
She always been like that?
Paranoia? Comes with a job. She may be the new kid on the block, but she's good.
She said you both know someone named Doug.
She told you about him?
Yeah. I figure they must be pretty good friends. I mean, she got involved in all this because of him.
They were engaged, actually. I guess she didn't tell you that.
Well done, Penny. I'm delighted to see you are on top of your game. A surprise. Life is full of them.
How did you find us?
Never lost you. I knew in which direction you were heading, so I decided I would use you and young Ashton to help bring his father in.
So that Manic can eat him alive? Like you said, I'm on top of my game.
You're wrong about Manic. He is not working for us on this.
Oh, come on, Ogilvy. You can do better than that.
He's right, Penny. We want Ashton alive.
And you expect me to believe that?
Penny, the agency did not hire Manic. It's Ashton. It's Ashton. Come on.
Oh, thank you.
Penny.
Let's just let go.
Dr. Ashton.
Go back!
All we need is time to talk. Now, let's be reasonable.
Easy, Mike.
Cover them both.
Just trust us, Mike. This can all be explained when we get Ashton. Hey!
Get out!
Oh, my God. Back off, asshole.
No, Mike, no. We'll tell you everything. Does it make more sense now?
According to this, Manic went renegade over a year ago. The CIA still suspect him on several murders since then, including Doug.
Dr. Ashton, I don't think you understand. what your father was.
I know exactly what my father was.
Your father was an outstanding geneticist. Nearly 40 years ago, he created something so dangerous, he referred to it as the enemy.
But why did he defect?
Because the KGB made a small quantity of it without telling him.
In the autumn of 1962, they tested it on a prison in Siberia. All the inmates and all the guards were dead within 48 hours.
Over 1,200 people, not a survivor.
He burned all his research, broke out over the Finnish border. I was based in Helsinki at the time.
So, he worked for you?
No. No, he said he would never, never work for his country's enemies.
What went wrong?
This did. Your father burned all his research, fine, but there was one sample left, locked in this airtight canister. Now, unfortunately, we can't open this because the toxin will mutate. It can't be duplicated.
Manick was after the genetic model of this stuff.
Yes. A little over a year ago, that prototype disappeared from Russia.
Disappeared? What do you mean?
Sold, stolen, we don't know. What we do know is that you can't leave this thing lying around. That's when we put Doug on the case.
And that's when Manick killed Doug.
Yes, we think so.
I contacted your father. He didn't want to know. He didn't want to help. He didn't believe us. He said it smelt like the KGB all over again. I told him we only wanted the antidote.
We'd have to duplicate the original research in order to find the antidote.
Exactly. Finally, we compromised. He said he would do the work, but not in a laboratory. That's when he came home to live with you. The day your assistant was killed, he called me. He said he would deliver it the next morning. His phone must have been tapped.
Mike, you worked with him. You must have a sense of how he thought. If you can recognize his original research from any of his notes, then maybe we can beat this thing. You're our best chance.
Quite frankly, Dr. Ashton, you are our only chance. This is everything of his we could find at the house.
Some of it makes sense, a lot of it doesn't.
How's the recovery going?
They have the car. And some of your father's effects. Current's very strong. It could take a while.
You got a hell of a lot of stuff here.
Can get people in to help you if you want.
They wouldn't know what they were looking at. I can read his shorthand.
Take a break.
Yeah, Maybe later. I'm starting to make a little headway here, finally. If I can just locate the gene source he's talking about.
Is this what he left at the hotel?
Yeah, it's just clothes and stuff. Let's see, I got that.
And this. God, your mother was beautiful. How old are you here?
Oh, I don't know, 5, I guess. God damn it! He documents 3 different control groups before he even identifies the gene source.
I know how hard this must be for you.
You know what? It'd be easier if he had organized.
I mean about losing him. I was thinking about what Ogilvy said, and I just couldn't help feeling sorry for him, you know? It must have been so hard for him knowing that he created something so horrible.
You know, I thought that I finally had him figured out after all these years. I thought he was jealous of me. You know, my awards, my grants. He wasn't jealous of me. He saw that I was becoming just like him. And he was afraid that what happened to him could happen to me.
I was being followed. Taylor?
Oh, my God.
Sorry, Doc. Your meeting's been canceled. Your friend talked too much.
Am I bothering you? Because if I'm bothering you, I can leave.
No, you're not bothering me. Penny, your friend Russell Henty, he told me about you and Doug.
Oh.
The only reason I bring it up is if what was gonna happen the other night in your apartment, if that's something that you don't want.
No, it's okay.
Really?
It's okay, really.
Oh, good. I'm glad.
So am I.
Hello.
Michael?
Who is this?
Michael, this is your father.
Dad?
Who is this? How did you get this number?
Look, I know this is a shock, but you have to believe me. I'm alive. I really am alive. The dam was a way to escape in case I was found.
Dad, I know everything, okay? I know
Michael,
why you...
Just listen. I came back for my work, but they found me.
There's not a lot of time, so you need to listen carefully.
Who is this?
Manic?
The toxin is set to explode in exactly 17 hours and 27 minutes in downtown Montreal. The deal goes like this. You turn over the formula, and I'll release Ashton in time to complete the antidote.
Well, hold on a minute. We haven't found it.
You were always good at finding things on our train trips to Quebec. Remember?
Dad.
Don't give it to them, Michael. I'd rather die.
What's going on, Dad?
Manic, you touch Ashton, and I swear to God I'll kill you.
You do exactly what I say, or the Montreal morgues will be overflowing tomorrow night. I'll check in later with more details.
You might as well kill me now, because my son will find the antidote. The fight!
Shut up, old man. Now get out to the base. Shadow his son and Agent Johnson if they leave. The old guy could be right.
DEFCON Bio 3 took effect 2 hours ago. The CIA contingent from Virginia is already working with the Canadian Emergency Response Team in a covert search of Montreal. Are there any questions?
God, that's one long shot. It could be anywhere. The chances of...
Slim, I know, but what is the alternative?
Evacuate the city.
Oh, and cause a panic.
Panic or death.
There's just not enough time.
What about Mike? There's still a chance that he might find the antidote on his own.
There's also the chance that he will drag his feet.
What are you talking about?
If he finds it, his father dies.
Do you honestly think that he jeopardized?
He is a civilian. You never know which way he will jump.
He's right there, Penny. Mike's under a lot of pressure. Maybe I should stick with it.
No, I want you in Montreal. Galvanize that search now.
Are you ready for your meeting, sir?
Yes. Right, I have a military liaison meeting. The rest of you know what you have to do. Get on with it.
Give you this.
What's that?
It's my secure cell number.
What do I need that for?
I don't feel good about this. You know, everything going through just one person. So, if Mike works out the formula, would you make sure that somebody else knows about it? I mean, not just Ogilvy.
Ogilvy.
Oh, listen, I don't know. I don't know. But, you know, all this started when Ashton told Ogilvy that he'd completed the formula. I mean, this is a nightmare. So let's be on the safe side, huh?
Krieger, let's go.
Right. And you take good care of Mike, will you?
I will.
Thanks, Penny.
Yeah.
Good.
What's going on?
Tell Ogilvy I didn't find it.
Are you sure?
I searched through all of it. I'm positive it's not here. It must be back at the house somewhere.
Okay, wait.
What?
No. Look, let's just check it out ourselves first, okay? If we find it, then we can tell Ogilvy.
Yeah, but why?
I'm not sure, but we may still be on the outside of this and not know it.
Come on.
Picked over pretty good. I mean, Ogilvy's even had the walls and the floors x-rayed.
Shit. It's gotta be here. He said we'd find it somewhere.
Or maybe it's not. Maybe...
What?
Maybe it's in Quebec.
Why Quebec?
Well, do you remember that your dad said something about finding things in Quebec?
Yeah.
So where did you guys go? I mean, maybe he hit something somewhere.
No. What he said was the train to Quebec. The train. phone. What my dad said, you know, about our trips to Quebec. He spent his time on our trips to Quebec just like he did the rest of our time together with his head and his research. We didn't play finding games. There's gotta be some kind of clue.
That's Drummondville.
Yeah. Yeah, but you know what? Maybe underneath.
You see anything?
No. It's just a bunch of wires and shit.
God, it's amazing how detailed this is.
Yeah. It's part of the fetish. Groups of them get together on the schedule like it was real.
Except the stops don't make any sense.
What?
Here on the board, you can't go through Sorel to get to Quebec from Montmagny. And over here, it's the same thing. Look, Quebec, Drummondville, Levy. You know, it's like your dad created this whole little world here.
Yeah, not just there. Look, that's not right. That doesn't work. Look, it's wrong. I mean, the stops, they're in the wrong place. The track, it curves back around and makes a figure eight, like... Oh, Jesus.
What are you doing?
Here. Look. Son of a bitch, would you look at the perfect double helix? The train set is the research. Somehow. Oh, it's possible.
What's possible?
That they're patterns.
Patterns?
Yeah, the stops and the times, they represent a splice variant on the Clostridial DNA strand. I need a computer.
My car.
Sherbrooke. Doesn't stop again till 8:24, Valleyfield.
That's 7 segments.
That's another lower region strand.
Okay, so now it's 8:24 to Valleyfield to Smith Falls. Stop at 8:27. That's 3 segments back up again.
I think we got it. I think we have the toxin formula.
Yeah, but there's only one more stop.
One. Are you sure just one? Because that's not enough for an antidote.
Into my email.
All right.
Oh, we're not gonna make it, Mike.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Come on. Okay, hey, what's your password? What's your password?
Oh, shit.
What's wrong? Give me it.
Oh, shit. My password's oh, shit.
Come on. No, go down!
Please.
Stop. No! Give me the access code, baby. Come on. Give me the code. Give me the fuck. G D 4 6 6 3 9 5 7 7 D 8 6 3 9 3 7 7 3 8. Did you get that?
No, we did not get it. We cannot access the file unless we have the access code. I got it. Oh, Jesus.
You just saved the world.
Cool.
Less than 2 hours. Are you sure you have it?
He's working on the antidote now.
All right, I want the toxin formula and everything else he's got so far. I have a team waiting in Montreal to start.
Well, you can forget it. It's not going to happen that way.
What are you talking about?
I think I can finish it myself.
Okay, listen to me, Dr. Ashton. I can't risk everything on you thinking you can finish it. That toxin is going to be released in less than 2 hours.
I'm well aware how much time we have. When I started this, the deal was if I found the antidote, the toxin formula would then be destroyed. I'm not turning that over to anybody.
I am not anybody. And if you don't think I won't go in there...
What? Torture me to get it? Because that's what you'd have to do.
I want to know the second he has that antidote.
Far pretty well. I didn't want to tell that bastard, but I think I'm getting close.
Really?
Yeah, Dad had me working on the antidote all along. I didn't even know it.
No, you're kidding me.
You remember the Bond with Dad project, the organic pesticide? Well, it's all in there. I just have to find out which variant is the correct one.
How many are you working with?
There were a lot.
How many?
1,500 or 1,600.
1,600?
Take it easy, though. I'm working on a recognition program. If there's anything similar, it'll find it in minutes.
You can do that.
Yeah, I can do that. I think.
Jump up.
Hey, Bob! Hey, Steph, where are you going? Stephanie, where are you? Come back here.
Stephanie.
Come on, honey.
That's it. We found the antidote.
Oh, thank God.
All right, I already talked to the CDC control team in Montreal. This should go.
Come to the phone right now. He's sucking on a 9mm barrel at the moment.
I know you found the toxin formula. I'll tell you how to make the trade.
Otherwise, your father's a dead man.
Email this to CDC straight away.
Yes, sir.
I'll call them and tell them it's on its way. Oh, and Penny, you'd better have your mic come along too in case they have any questions.
Yes, sir. Mike?
Thank you.
voice recording.
The East Road leading to the old steelworks.
I know the place.
Good. You've got an hour.
It'll be on a disc.
If I can access the toxin formula, you will get your father.
Confirm call recording deletion. Recording deleted.
Wait for the spray down. We hold everyone in secure zone for a 48-hour quarantine and administer additional antitoxin as needed. Where is he?
He deleted the toxin formula out of the computer and went to trade it for his father.
Check the gate. I want to stop.
Right, sir. Give me the gate.
No new voice recording.
Nothing. No call came. He must have been contacted some other way.
Ashton drove out the East Gate a few minutes ago. Looks like he stole a pool car.
Well, they get the number. Put out an APB. Go on, move it. This does not change the containment plan. Penny, you already know what I have to do, don't you? Cannot risk anyone getting their hands on that toxin formula. I have to put a termination notice out on Mike and his father.
Montreal caused panic but little damage, but the speed of response by emergency crews has led some people to speculate that the city already knew about the bomb. Both the mayor's office and the armed forces refused to comment. A busload of elementary school children are among several hundred people sent to hospital as a precaution. Doctors say there's no need to panic, but anyone near the explosion with nausea and flu-like symptoms should report to the nearest hospital immediately. Tracy McKee, First News, Montreal.
Looks like our guys were right. They have the antidote.
I knew he'd find it.
Yeah, but he still has to trade for you. He's here.
Hey,
This is your disc. The liquid is acid. Any sudden moves by me and the disc takes a swim. Where's my father?
Inside.
Bring him out.
Michael, please, don't do this.
Send him down. You want to play spin the bottle?
All right. Cut him free.
Good. You understand how this game is played, then? Far enough. He comes the rest of the way by himself.
Michael, don't give it to them.
Get in the car, Dad.
Michael.
Just do it.
Do now.
Fuck the disc. Get them alive. He's got the formula in his head.
Come on, come on.
You drive.
Just get us out of here.
Losing speed.
Go!
Jesus Christ. Krieger's inside.
I know.
Manic's in there too. He's after Mike and his father.
Reeves, 3 o'clock. X.
You knew?
I suspected. I had a tracer on his car after he left Montreal an hour ago. While I was waiting for my backup team, you, young Ashton, decided to get in the middle of everything.
So you mean that Krieger put me on this, thinking that I would blow it so that he could get to Ashton?
You proved him wrong. That's what matters.
What the hell are you doing, Dad? Come on, we've got to get out of here.
No, Michael. I can't do it.
Krieger is in here and he's gunning for us. Come on.
Even if we beat Krieger, there'll always be someone after me. It's always been like this. The hardest thing I ever did was leave you.
I always thought...
No, Michael. You were only safe because I disappeared. That model.
It's water. The disk is empty. I deleted the formula. You didn't think I'd risk the world for a grouchy old man, did you?
Oh, yeah. You're my son, all right. I've always been very proud of you, Michael. You've become a fine man. Don't let them find me. Any of them.
Cell phone.
Yes, why?
I have an idea.
Where is your father?
He was never here. Krieger killed him before they ever got here. Now I'll never even know where the body is.
You're probably right. Where's the disc?
Come on, baby.
I'm sorry you lost your dad.
You know what? I think I finally found it.